Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. I wanted to do a quick little lesson for you on the difference between Teams and SharePoint and OneDrive. And in particular, I'm going to be comparing the file storage, the file sharing features of these applications that are all part of Microsoft 365. And I'm going to do a presentation to compare them first, and then I'm going to do a demo of it live as well. So make sure you stay to the end to see that demo and see the differences for yourself. So let's start with the presentation here. All right, so as I said, this is all part of Microsoft 365. You have OneDrive included, the Teams included, and SharePoint included. So they're all part of the same package. It's just a matter of which one do I use and for what reason, okay? So I'm gonna break it down based on hopefully something that makes more sense to you in terms of how you work with your files, and that is on your computer or within your office. So on your own computer, you usually would be saving your files, that the files that belong to you, that you created, that you work with the most, those would usually be saved into My Documents. Now, the files that are the company files that everybody should have a copy of, or I shouldn't say copy, everyone should have access to, that maybe the forms, the templates, certain reference materials that everybody should know and see, those files should be shared somewhere centrally for the entire company. And that usually, in a typical office, is on a server. So that server lets everyone share those files. Now, in the cloud world, and when we talk about being able to access these files from anywhere, you could still do that with the My Documents and server as long as you have some way of getting into your system that is remote. And so that could be a VPN, or that could be remote desktop, or a number of other things that your IT person could certainly take care of for you. Now, if you're looking at Microsoft Office or Microsoft 365 as your solution for using your files remotely, then the programs that you're looking at to help you with that are OneDrive and SharePoint. Now, OneDrive, I want you to compare that one to the My Documents. So OneDrive is named OneDrive because it's meant for one person. Okay, you could share your files with other people. You can pick and choose who you want to share with, but it's really set up for one person. And so I'll show you what that looks like. I'll even demonstrate it afterwards as well so you can get what I mean by this. I see a lot of people using OneDrive and they're like, oh, we could just share all of our files through OneDrive. No, don't do that as a company. You can share your own personal files through OneDrive if you choose to, rather than emailing them. That's better, is to share them through OneDrive, but don't have the whole company set up on OneDrive. If you want to share files, if there's files that are meant for everybody to be accessing and sharing and looking at and using, then those files should be kept on SharePoint. And so look at the word here, SharePoint, for sharing. Okay, sharing is caring. So if you have a company and there's a number of you that want to share information, SharePoint is for sharing. OneDrive is for one person. Okay, I know you might be making fun of me here, but anyways, I hope you get the idea as I'm exaggerating the point here. Both of them you can share information with. I'm not saying you can't. I'm just going to show you how one is going to be better long term for you as an organization instead of the other one. Okay, so OneDrive personal, SharePoint for shared information. Okay, let's move on from here. All right, so this is how OneDrive can look. So a number of file folders, something that we're all familiar with, a number of file folders that we've seen in the past for files that we have. So this is an example of what my OneDrive looks like. Now, the advantage to OneDrive is that I can sync those file folders that are shared on the Microsoft OneDrive platform on the cloud. I can sync those to my computer. So then I can actually access them without having to go on the web portal without logging into the web to OneDrive. Plus I can access them if I have no internet. Okay, so that's the advantage of the syncing. Syncing is not creating a backup of it or a copy of it. It's just letting you have a place for you to access it when you're not online or instead of being online. Okay, so that's OneDrive. You can do the same kind of syncing, by the way, with SharePoint. So this is what SharePoint can look like. So a little bit fancier than your typical OneDrive screen. Now, how SharePoint looks depends on who sets it up for you and how they make it look. It can look like a fancy little website, or it can just look like a number of files. This is a plain example of SharePoint with, I have news showing here in the middle, but that doesn't even have to be there. It could just be showing documents. Okay, so it depends on who sets this up for you, or if you're gonna set it up, then how you wanna set it up for the people that are gonna be accessing it. So I'll demo this for you in a few minutes. Now, why I really emphasize SharePoint to you is there's a number of reasons as stated on this slide here. So it is like a website, so maybe it's a friendlier looking place for you to get information. Probably the biggest factor why SharePoint is a better idea for your organization is because of the permissions. You can customize the permissions for any area of SharePoint so that you can decide who can read this, who can add more information to it, edit it, which is read and write, by the way, who can delete something, who can't delete, you know, so lots of different options for who can do what with the files. And that's where SharePoint comes in. So, and it's a document management system as well. And so I talk to a lot of my clients about some of the record management systems that they might be using. This has a lot of extra capabilities built into it, such as, you know, if I want to have approval for documents, as soon as someone fills in a form, I want that form to go to a certain person, I can build that right into SharePoint. And it can have it has an approval flow. And there's all kinds of other flows or automation you can build in with SharePoint, as well as getting more details on your file. So if you want to know more than just the size of the file, the date it was last updated, you can show other columns of information within your SharePoint. So that's kind of cool. Collaborating, well, more than one person can work on a file at the same time. That's true of SharePoint. That's also true of OneDrive. So that's not really a difference there. Sharing files internally as well as externally. Same goes with SharePoint and OneDrive. You can do those two things. Now let's look at the third option here. So Microsoft Teams. So this is just a quick screenshot of what Teams could look like with the kind of the opening screen, so to speak. And Teams has the files built into it. The files that are built into Teams, though, are coming from SharePoint. So even though there's a Files tab in Teams, you're really not saving files in Teams per se. Teams is saving those files into SharePoint. So just so you know, Teams equals SharePoint as far as files are concerned. But Teams gives you a lot more than just files and meetings, which most people are pretty accustomed to these days. Teams does a lot more than that. So what does it do? I like to think of Teams as a place that houses everything. And so you can choose to be in the team house and do all these things, or you could choose to just, hey, go get a file from your OneDrive or from your SharePoint. You don't have to be in Teams to get a file. But let's talk about what it houses. So it houses the ability for you to chat with people in the team or even outside the team. You can share files, of course. We've already mentioned that. You can share tasks. You can delegate tasks to other people and have that all viewable by the team themselves. You can, of course, have remote meetings with people within your team internally. And you can also set up remote meetings so that you can have meetings with people that are external to your organization as well. You can store notes in Teams. There's a wiki system for notes. There is also the ability to tie in OneNote, which is another Office 365 product. And there is polls that you can do to ask people their opinions on stuff. And you know what? There are hundreds and hundreds of apps you can tie into Teams. So that's kind of why I call it the house that houses things. And you can, of course, also connect to other file locations. So this is where OneDrive comes in. So if I'm in Microsoft Teams and I'm looking for a file, I can look for that file within the files area of my team, or which is coming from SharePoint, or I can look for my file that I know I have on OneDrive, or I know maybe I have on Dropbox. Maybe you're still using Dropbox, or you're using maybe an iCloud product as well. I shouldn't say product, or maybe you're using iCloud as well. So it will connect to those locations so you can look at those files while you're in Teams. So it's kind of like, hey, stay in this house and get all your work done. So that's the idea behind it. So let's now do a quick little demo of which of these, what this all looks like, okay? All right, so this is my live OneDrive location. So I'm just on the web here looking at OneDrive. So you can see just a bunch of file folders and notebooks and such. If I go into a file folder, let's say I go into courses, for instance, then you're gonna see maybe more file folders and some files as well, okay? What I want you to see with OneDrive though is the sharing. So if I go to the left side here and go to shared, this is why I don't suggest this is good long term. I don't want you to take your organization and say, hey guys, let's all share our files through OneDrive. There's, you know, we can just, OneDrive is so easy for sharing. It is, but there is no organization for sharing other than you have this big long list of things that were shared with you and a big long list of things that were shared by you. You can certainly search through the list. You could find out the activity of those files within the list, but it doesn't let you group them and all that kind of stuff. So you can say, hey, these files are about courses, these files are about something else. So that's kind of why I would not recommend this being the only method of your organization sharing information. Once in a while, hey, fine, do it. Or if you're a small organization, there's only two of you, then maybe, yeah, do it. But if there's a lot of people within your organization that want to share information, your best bet is to go to something a bit more robust, okay? And so by that, I mean SharePoint. So let's take a quick peek at SharePoint. Here's the same site that I was on within Teams. And if I go into Teams coaching, let's say, then you see, oh, there's some folders there and there's some files here. It even gives me a little picture of a file I've opened. And then if I go into a folder, I see more files. All right, so that's kind of what, and I'm not showing a whole lot here. This screen that I'm showing doesn't have a lot of area to view these files, but as I was saying earlier, you can certainly make it so that your file area is a lot wider and you can see a lot more columns of information about those files. But sharing really is every SharePoint site is a shared area. So if you want to be organized with your sharing, that's the way it's built. It's built to be organized with your sharing. So just to show you what I mean there, right now I'm in the sample SharePoint site. I'm going to go to SharePoint at the top here just to go to my, actually let's just go up here. All right, so I'm just in my main SharePoint area, and this is a list of all the teams that I have visited recently. And so this is just showing you that there's a different site for different reasons for your organization. So that's where that sharing is more organized. Okay, now let's go one step further. Let's take a look at how this looks within Teams. So if I go to Teams here, I'm in the sample team. And so that's the same name as the SharePoint site, by the way. And I'm in Teams coaching like I was in SharePoint. And so you see the same files I was looking at earlier. And if I click on this folder here, you're gonna see the same files inside that folder. So this is just showing you the information that's in SharePoint through your Teams application. So it's really the same thing, but Teams gives you more. And that's why you wanna learn about Teams, you wanna use Teams so that you can share more information and get more collaboration. All right, so those are your differences. I hope that helps you understand the difference between SharePoint, OneDrive, and Teams. And if you need further help on any of this stuff, please reach out to me. I teach all these programs and I'd love to help you further. Okay, bye for now.